Everyone wears textiles. Today, when you woke up, you put on a garment, and that experience is shared amongst everyone alive. What happens to the clothing that's once in our closet when we're done wearing it? Number one, the garments in our closet get thrown away. Number two, donations. Of those clothes that you donate, most people don't realize that over 80% of it go directly to landfill. Most clothing isn't actually recycled. Cycora is a fully circular polyester regenerated from end-of-life textiles. What this enables for the first time ever is for the number one material in fashion, polyester, to not go to landfill. We're able to turn an old t-shirt into a new t-shirt, and we wouldn't recognize the difference in quality. Old clothing ends up in stuffing in pillows, in cushions, places that aren't back in our old closet. We're trying to change that. The Ambercycle story is one of unexpected partnership. I met my co-founder, Moby. We were both roommates at UC Davis.
Hi, my name is Akshay Sethi. I'm co-founder and CEO of Ambercycle.
We would spend a lot of time hanging out, talking about the different problems in the world. Textile waste was definitely a surprise problem. It just started with a simple question. What happens to all of our old stuff? Every year, over 100 billion garments are made and go to landfill. That's over 37,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools. And actually, less than 1% of that is made back into new clothing. That's because the textiles in our closet are intricate blends. This blending makes it really hard to deal with at its end of life. Our process changes that. Our first garment was a bike jersey, and it took us 5 years to make that first garment. And although it wasn't the most comfortable, for us, it was a major proof point. The waste products of the past can become the resources for the future. The next frontier for us is getting to commercial scale and really delivering the impact that we need. So this is end-of-life textile material. All of the buttons, zippers, all of this material is removed. We separate all of the loose fibers, but the material itself is still blended. And so after we have the shredded material, our process begins. What we do is we separate the polyester at the molecular level. And then we can purify that material, removing the dyes, additives, all the stuff that ends up on our old clothing. Our output is a chip. It is the same material that's made traditionally from oil, but our chips are made entirely from old clothing. There's a much lower carbon footprint to it. It can be used just like normal polyester is used. It's able to make all the same garments that we know and love, but just from a sustainable raw material source.
All of today's Dacron polyester at prices that won't cost you a fortune.
Polyester has a fascinating history. It was invented in 1941, not too long ago. And when it came out, it was viewed as a miracle material. The strength, durability, and affordability of this material made it highly desirable for a lot of different applications. Think of a rain jacket that keeps you dry, or a puffer jacket that keeps you warm. These properties weren't possible before polyester. But over the years, this has meant that over 2/3 of every fiber used in apparel comes from polyester. The polyester fiber takes hundreds of years to decompose in our environment, meaning that it's gonna be there for years, decades, even centuries, unless we do something about it. And we're not the only solution that's needed to achieve this zero waste industry goal that we all have. We need more solutions in manufacturing, transparency and traceability, and easy to understand customer touch points. People actually want to see this change. The shift to more intentional choices is starting to happen. That choice tells companies that you want materials that are made in harmony with nature. We have enough material in circulation to clothe the next six generations of humans. We want to use these materials as resources for the future.